So, last class we discussed about the laws of reflection and what is light and how the light reflects everything. Now, in this chapter we will learn about different type of reflectors from where the light can reflect. The light can reflect from the object that is called the mirrors. The mirror is used to reflect the lights. So mirrors are different types. So here today we learn about this. So there first in our house we see the plane mirrors. So this is the plane mirror. Normally you have to draw the plane mirror in this way. That's a straight line, and this type of lines you have to draw on the back side of the mirror, because this opposite, this is the reflecting surface. This is the reflecting surface. This is the rough surface. From there, the reflection will not take place. Only the regular reflection will take place from this surface. Okay. So that is why they're polished. Or you can say the polished surface is this one, and the rough surface is the opposite direction. So in the back side, the reflection will be there. That is the diffuse reflection. But in the front side, there will be always the regular reflection will be there. So, types of mirrors are, the first one is the plane mirror, and next one is the concave mirror and the convex mirror. This is the concave mirror and the convex mirror. So, what is concave mirror? You just bend this one, this plane mirror, so that the reflecting surface will go inside. Then it will become the concave mirror. So, this reflecting surface is inside. So, then it is called the concave mirror. And when the reflecting surface is bulging outside, so in this case the reflecting surface is bulging outside, then is known as the convex mirror. So while you can see this type of mirrors, so you just take a spoon, this newly polished spoon, if you take, so outside of the spoon, this side outside of the spoon is convex surface, and inside of the spoon is concave surface. So inside will become concave and outside will become convex. So there are three types of mirror. First one is plane mirror, concave mirror and convex mirror. Now in this picture we'll see that how the image is formed in concave and convex surface. See, this is the concave surface. Concave surface, and this is convex surface. This convex surface and this is concave surface. So different types of images formed. So next we'll discuss about why the different type of image is forming. And now this is the picture of the plane mirror which we'll see in your house. This is the plane mirror. So this is exactly plane and flat, but this one are bulges. Now in these mirrors, few things are there. In case of concave mirror, what will happen? In case of concave mirror, this one. So when the ray, there is one particular point. If you draw a line like this way, then this line is known as the principal axis. This line should be known as very straight to this one. It's called the principal axis. It's called the principal axis. Now, this is called a pole P, and this is the curvature of the mirror. This will have the part of a sphere. The center of this big sphere is known as the center of curvature, C. Okay, and from the pole and the center of curvature, if we draw a middle point here, that is called the focus. Why it is called focus? If the parallel beam of light is coming and falling on this mirror, this parallel beam of light will meet in this particular point. So that is called the focus. If the parallel beams are coming and it will meet in this particular point. So that is why this is called the focus. Now what will happen in case of convex mirror? When the parallel beams are coming, this is also the principal axis. So principal axis will draw in this way, principal axis. This is the pole. So when the parallel beams are coming, then this is also having center of curvature. If you draw a circle, the center of this circle is called the center of curvature. Okay. Now if the parallel beams are coming, then we'll draw the perpendicular in this line. So we'll draw the perpendicular, we'll draw the perpendicular in this way. Then perpendicular will always pass through the center of curvature. So if this is angle of incidence I, then it will reflect in the same angle in this way. Same angle is angle of reflection R. So if this line, if I draw dotted line, so it will it seems that you are coming from this particular point. This point is known as the focus. Okay. So here the rays are reflecting and meeting. So here also if you draw a perpendicular, the perpendicular will be like this way. Here the parallel beams of lines are coming, parallel beam of lights are coming, and they are meeting in a particular point, and that is called the focus. Here the parallel rays are coming and they are reflecting, but it seems they are coming from a particular point inside the mirror, so this is called the focus. So in this case, the actual ray of lights are meeting here, so that is why they are called the real focus. In this case, it seems the light is coming out from this particular point, so this is known as the virtual focus. So what we learned today? We learned today different types of mirrors, and which one is concave, which one is convex mirror, what is the plane mirror, and how to draw the mirror. This is the procedure to draw the mirror. Which one is pole, which one is the principal axis, which one is the center of curvature, and which one is the focus. And a little bit simple ray diagrams of the convex mirror and the concave mirrors. So thank you very much.